having a look inside your eyes at your cataracts, just to see how they're affecting you and whether we need an operation to remove them. So, cataracts. Within the eyeball. So this is the front of the eye, and this is the back of the eye, and cataract develops within the lens. It becomes cloudy and scatters the light, and this leads to glare, and it can also affect your vision. Okay, and as we know, there are two main types. Two main causes of cataract. First one is age, and the second one is ultraviolet radiation. So, one of the things that cataracts can affect is your contrast sensitivity. So, your first test is going to be your contrast sensitivity. If you wouldn't mind covering your left eye for me, take a look at this chart. Now, this is checking your contrast sensitivity. So if you could read the letters as far as you can go, please. Good. Excellent. Yes, contrast is not too bad there. Not brilliant, but not bad. Okay, cover the left eye. Read as far as you can for me, telling me the letters on the chart. Good, good, excellent. So the contrast is about equal in each eye. Very good, thank you. Keeping your left eye covered again, I've just got some near tests, some near vision tests. So just having a look here. Which block can you read down to? Excellent. And how's the data looking there? Okay, a little bit blurry. Okay. The sat nav. Okay. Just having a look at the train ticket. Okay, still a little bit blurry. Very blurry. Okay. And we have some packaging labels. Packaging labels. Very blurry. So the left eye is looking more blurry than the right eye. Okay. Let's give you some bigger print for the left. Too blurry to read. Okay, thank you. Excellent. Just a quick check of your distance vision. Cover the left eye again for me, please. And just say the letters. Okay, a bit too blurred. Let's go bigger. Can you see this letter? Okay, good. Cover the left eye. Thank you. We are going to check the pressure of the eye now, so we have to pop a little eye drop into the eye. It does sting a little bit, just for a few seconds. Okay, just looking up for me, please, and I'll pop the drop in. at the other eye. Excellent, thank you. Just blink for me. Give it a few seconds. I'll get the machine set up. Just want you to look over my shoulder. It's probing the end of the machine. Gently twitches the eye, but you won't feel anything, okay? So looking straight ahead for me. I'll just bring this in closely. Good. Almost there. Okay. And blink for me, and it's just going to come against the eye now. Good, and I'll read the pressure. That looks to be 18 millimetres of mercury, thank you. And the left eye now. Start at 18. Okay, looking straight ahead. Okay, now blink for me. And there we go, against the eye. Let's have a look. Okay, if you sit back for me now. Excellent, so the pressure in the left. 20 millimetres of mercury. Thank you. Let's do a quick colour vision test with both eyes. This is a new test for you today. Okay. Looking at the colours here, is there any colour that looks different to the rest? Is the one that stands out? And down here. Good. And any colours looking different on there? And any different colours on there? Good. And last one. Before we dilate the pupil, I'm just going to have a little look at the side of your eye using the shadow test. The shadow test. So just looking straight ahead. Okay, just over my shoulder. I'll check the angle of the eye with the shadow test. The shadow test. Okay. Looking over my left shoulder now. Let's check the shadow. Shadow test with the left eye. Left eye. Good. Almost there. Brilliant. Thank you. Okay, so we have another eye drop to pop in the eye. This shouldn't sting as much as the first one. But this eye drop will make the vision a little bit blurry. A little bit blurry for a few hours. Okay, so now driving today. Are you ready? Looking up for me, please. Okay, and the other eye, looking up again for me, please. Good. Okay, take a few blinks for me now. I'm going to have a little look with the magnifying glass just at the front of the eye, and then we'll have a look at the back of the eye in a little bit more detail. Okay, so looking over my right shoulder, not going to touch the eye, I'm just going to have a magnified look. Looking to the left for me, and up to the ceiling, and looking to the right hand side, and looking down, straight ahead again, okay, onto the left eye, looking over my shoulder into the distance, forming up to the ceiling and to the right hand side, and looking down to the floor. Very good. Okay, so the external area of the eye is looking fine. Let's have a look at the cataract in the back of the eye in a little bit more detail. Okay, so we have this special magnified lens which will allow me to see the back of the eye much better, and we will be using the good old ophthalmoscope. Okay, ophthalmoscope, so just looking over my shoulder into the distance now. I'll do the right. Use the green light now. Okay. Yes, there is some significant cataract in the back of the eye there. And the blue light. Okay, let's check the left eye now. Okay, keep looking over my left shoulder. Feel that the cataract in the left eye is certainly a little bit more advanced compared to the right eye. So we have a little bit more cataract in this eye. And not to worry, we can certainly refer you if you'd like an operation. Very good look at the back of the eye here, and of the cataract as well. Perfect, thank you. Okay, so that's all the tests. There are certainly cataracts in both eyes, more advanced, excuse me, in the left eye. So I feel that we can make a referral to the local hospital to have the cataract removed. So I will arrange the referral for you. You will be seen within 2 months, and that will mean the hospital will call for you, where they will do some pre-assessments at the back of both eyes. They will dilate again, and then they will book you in for a cataract operation within probably a week from that date. So good luck, and we will see you around 4 to 6 weeks after the operation.